Hello friends, welcome to Amit Thinks. In this video, we'll be learning about tables, how we can create a table on a web page using Bootstrap. So here we will learn how we can create a new table on a web page. The classes we'll be using are table striped. Table striped are used to create a striped table. We will see later. Bordered table, it will add a border to a table. However, you may have seen on some tables on other website that it shows the hover action when you will mouse over your cursor. So the color of the cell will change on mouse hover. For that you need to use the table hover class. Table dark to create a dark color table. You will see later. To create a borderless table, that is the default one, will have some borders, it will remove it. It won't have any border. These are the contextual classes which you can use for table cells. Primary, this can be used to set a cell, table cell, with important information. Table success for success action on a table cell. For danger action, add info using table info. Set warning action. Active adds hover color to the cell. Secondary, it adds let's important info. It will add dark gray color to the table. It will add light gray color to the table. With that, to set color on table headers, you need to use the table header class. It will have a dark color, and if you will use light with t head, it will add light color. Now let's move on and create a basic table using the table class. Now you can see this is a sample example of Bootstrap table. Here we have a container class that brings fixed width. With that, S3 tag is for selections and table element is used with the class table to create a basic table. Header is player name, age, sports. Here on the right you can see. And we have added three values, records of three players. First is Amit, next is Kevin, and third is Lynette. So now moving further, we have added a table here. You can easily add a table using it. To add more rows, you need to just add the content. Let's say I've added another row. So we can change it to Tom, age. You can add any sample thing. You can add your own content. I'll add table tennis to it. Okay, now I'll run it. Here you can see a table is visible. Now we will add a striped table. For that, you need to use the table striped class. I've added a table striped class with a table class. Now I'll run it. Here you can see the striped table have been created. Now let's move on to table bordered class. To add a table border, now I'll add table bordered here. Now you can see we have a border to a table. Now I'll add table hover, table dark, and borderless. I'll run it. Now on hovering on any cell, on any row, it is highlighting it. So this is the role of table hover. Now I'll add borderless. This will remove the basic borders, the default borders. I'll run it. So on adding table borderless, after running, all the borders have been removed. So now we will add the dark class. It will darken the table. Here you can see we have a darkened table now, using just a simple class table dark. Now we have reached this section and completed the classes. Now we will add contextual classes to table cell. So let's add it one by one. Starting with the table primary. Now let's change it to the basic one, bordered. Okay. So now I'll go to any cell and let's say here I'll add class is equal to table primary, and let's see the changes. Primary is used to add information. So here you can add information in a table cell. Here you can see it has been changed to primary color. For danger, you need to change it to danger, table danger. That will add a dangerous section. Here you can see. Now for warning, let's say you need to add warning message to a table like do not cross, or messages like do not touch. Now the color will change. In the same way, for adding info, we have table info. Color will again change for the cell. Now let's see what all are remaining. We can add active also for hover color, secondary dark and light. Let's go for it. I'll add active. Now I'll add secondary. To add secondary information, I'll add dark. It will darken my cell, and light. Light will provide a light gray color. On adding table light, here you can see on Amit, light gray color is visible for the player name. Let's add dark again and see the difference. Dark. In the same way, you can use table secondary to add less important info. Now I'll just copy it and add primary to it to let's see the difference. Now I'll add info to it, and here I'll add let's say danger if we haven't added it above. Okay, so now I'll run it and see the difference. Here you can see the different colored cells are visible. In this way, you can use different types of classes. I'll change it to dark and I'll change it to light. As you can see, light gray color and dark gray color. So now let's move further. The last two classes are T head dark and T head light. This will give dark color to header as well as a light color to header respectively. So I'll use the T head dark class. So I'll add it to header. Yeah. Class is equal to. Now let's see what happens. Now you can see we have a darkened cell for header. For lighter one, you need to add light. Now you can see table head is lighter. So by using a simple class, you can easily change the color. So in this video, we saw how we can create a table in Bootstrap. With that, we also saw how we can use different classes to create a basic table, stripe table, a table with border, a table with hover, as well as darken and lighten tables. We can also remove all the borders using borderless class. With that, we can use the contextual classes also for coloring the tables. Like for primary, it will add a blue color. In the same way, it will add different colors according to the action. For success, danger, info, warning, etc. With that, you can also darken and lighten the cell using the dark and light table class. For headers, Bootstrap 4 is providing us with two classes, T head dark for darken one header and T head light for lighter header. Thank you for watching the video. If you like the video, then please share it, please subscribe to our channel. In the next video, we'll be learning about how to create a responsive table in Bootstrap. Thank you for watching.